Then the angel departed from her. I like to immerse myself in that moment when there was neither the angel nor anything else. And Our Lady was there, a 15-year-old girl alone with the event, which she didn't yet feel within her, couldn't feel within her, but that she understood. She understood that it had happened and would develop. Alone, there was nothing left to lean on. In that moment, she reached the apex of what is called faith, the faith. She understood that within, behind that apparent silence of things, the great mystery for whom humanity was made, who until then everyone, especially these people, awaited in various ways, had happened.
Thank you. or something irrational, precisely because we do not see any reasons for it. Because mercy is proper to being, to the infinite mystery. He came to dwell among us. This is the event in the presence of him who alone can reveal the mystery of things, the mystery of being that is the mystery of life. Revealing the mystery means revealing something that remains a mystery. No man has ever seen his face, the face of being. No man. But you, O child who comes, you came to reveal this mystery, the mystery that no man has ever seen.
May our memory be fixed on him who burst forth in a new song. May our life become new, because the song of life is life itself. May it become new, new every day, may it be renewed. This is the fruit of the certainty of his mercy, of the certainty that his power is greater than our weakness, certainty of God with us. Only from this certainty can joy come. Only from the certainty of God with us can joy come. There is no other source.
Lay down and be strong.
Mary's life was our home but for the mission. That life of the shepherds, that before they saw him, before they received the announcement, was theirs, was no longer theirs, but was mission. Even had they stayed home with their wives and children and their flocks. But was their message in their surroundings, the message in the village where they lived, the message they handed on, that they told themselves and others? That life that was theirs until that moment would never again be their own. In the same way, our life is no longer our own. Our life is mission. Our life is communicating what has happened to us, making our presence community, making the presence of those that we meet community, renewing the miracle of his presence, renewing his event, renewing with others the event that he has brought about with us, with others, with things, with everything.
Thank you.
Being Christian is not the result of an ethical choice or a lofty idea, but the encounter with an event, a person, which gives life a new horizon and a decisive direction. Christianity is something that is given to us and that appears to us as given, as an announcement, an unforeseen and unforeseeable reality that didn't exist and is here, that couldn't be and is present, an absolute newness. Just think of what the shepherds must have felt at the angel's announcement, or the wise men at the announcement of which the stars.